Wisconsin's largest bank is under new ownership. Now at 5, we'll break down the details of the M&I deal and take a look at what it means for bank customers. A Canadian company bought out the Badger State's largest bank. M&I says customers should not expect to see any major changes. 12 News reporter Nick Bohr is live at M&I's headquarters in downtown Milwaukee. And Nick, what about the M&I name, which has been around for what, 163 years?
Right, a long, long time, Kathy. The new owner of the Bank of Montreal also owns Chicago-based Harris Bank. They say they haven't decided yet how to brand this new acquisition here. It's a $4 billion deal, a deal which will close in July.
I think it's really a time of renewal.
With that, the CEO of the Bank of Montreal announced the takeover of M&I, the troubled Wisconsin-based bank that took a major hit in the real estate bust, especially in Arizona and Florida.
When we combine these banks, we will move into a position of having the 15th largest personal and commercial bank in the United States, and we'll essentially have a very, very strong market position in the Midwest.
The Bank of Montreal already owns Chicago-based Harris Bank, which recently broke into the Milwaukee market. Still, the CEOs of both say there's very little overlap and no decision's been made about which brand will prevail.
Both banks will continue until the merger is completed. M&I will be M&I and Harris Bank will be Harris Bank, and I think we'll have to spend a little bit of time thinking about exactly how the branding presents itself.
Milwaukee Mayor Tom Barrett says it's difficult to lose a corporate headquarters here, but he's been assured the Bank of Montreal is committed here.
I talked to the CEO of M&I this morning. He assured me that there will continue to be civic involvement, that there's a lot of areas where the two businesses don't overlap, so I think that's a good sign for employment. And I'm guardedly optimistic that we'll see more capital invested.
And M&I's boss says even if the name changes to Harris down the road, customers can expect a smooth transition.
If you're an M&I customer, what you have is a bigger organization behind you, more products and services behind you. I think you're going to see it get even better. But you're going to have the same people serving you that you had serving you yesterday.
Now, the CEO of the Bank of Montreal says he will expect some job cuts here, especially in the areas of data systems and call centers. But there is also concern tonight from community leaders about the loss of a corporate headquarters in Milwaukee. We'll have that part of the story coming up on 12 News at 6. Live downtown, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.
All right, see you at 6 o'clock, Nick. And M&I Bank is the largest Wisconsin-based bank. M&I was founded in 1847. The bank has 192 offices throughout the state of Wisconsin. They also have locations in Arizona, Florida, Indiana, Minnesota, Missouri, and Nevada. Today's sale was good news for M&I investors. The bank's stock closed at $6.85 per share today. That's up 18% from yesterday's closing price of $5.79 per share.